Hey, what's up guys? Simon here. So, we thought it would be a good idea to go back and cut through all the noise and clip out some of the segments we'd done on specifically the guys we drafted. So, we've started here with Chase Claypool, who we spoke about at the end of February when we did our second wide receiver episode. We'll try and do this with every prospect, assuming that we have in fact spoke about them in recent weeks. So, without further ado, here's what we said about Chase Claypool back in February.
Well, Dave, who's next on your list? We've got to you, not had one of yours yet.
I had Chase Claypool.
Talk about Red Star guys.
Yeah. Just sort of, he's a bit of a sort of a, I suppose a bit like Duvernay. He's sort of a, again, sort of a bit of a bully, bit of a nasty, mean streak to him. Mm. From what I've seen of tape, not that I've watched all of his tape, obviously. Solid blocker, good blocker, not afraid to stick his head in there and bully guys around. Potentially, I don't know how much. What was his time? I don't know. What I didn't see.
Unbelievably fast.
4.42, which is insane for the size that he is. Right. I mean, I almost didn't believe it when when he showed it.
I think you and me were chatting online at the time. It just, what the hell?
It's just when I watched the tape. When you watch the tape, he doesn't seem particularly fast. So I sort of marked him down as, oh, maybe he's sort of like a slot guy, sort of across the middle kind of person, not a guy that's going to burn people. But when you look at that, like, wow, yeah, maybe he is. And maybe he has got that ability.
That is a little bit of a red flag. It's worth pointing out as well. I mean, he doesn't play with 4.42 speed, right?
I don't know, because what I saw is that he's a boundary receiver, right? He stems well outside and beats his man. So that would speak to that he's got that kind of quick straight line burning speed, and then the size to box out the cornerback.
Yeah.
But I mean, he's gotten. It would be interesting to see what he did in the three cone, because I'd like to know what, because he's. I mean, although he's got a decent double move, he doesn't really run a kind of very sophisticated route tree. But what I like about him is I think he's the ideal weapon for a kind of your 2 minute drill.
Mm.
I mean, like the sideline catches you see him do regularly, you know, it's perfect for that, you know, controlling the clock. And he'd just be an absolute, you know, dominant threat with the size and speed for that kind of situation.
He's another guy that's sort of got like a tight end build, isn't he? He's another one of those big dudes. Is he the biggest in the
There was talk of him moving to tight end, I think, Gav, right? Potentially, or some teams wanted him to. I actually wrote down, can't get T. Higgins? How about this dude? this guy wasn't particularly on my radar, actually, before we saw him at the Combine yesterday, so I kind of crammed a little bit on him today. I watched a lot of him today, and I'm really impressed by him. I think he's very much the kind of guy we're talking about, Gav, that I'm really interested in the Steelers taking, which is something that I don't think the Steelers necessarily have in Juju, Washington, DJ. I think this is something that we're missing. Big, big physical dude who can just win through contact. He's difficult to move, right? He's just, like you said, boxing DBs out and high-pointing the football. And once he's like kind of rooted to the ground, that's it, right? he's gonna dive up there and get it, and you're not going to get him off his stance. I did put, you know, you don't see a ton of juice, but the fact that he runs that 4.42 just rises his upside physically and makes you think, well, you know, maybe there is a little bit more juice there that you didn't always see on tape, but I think the ceiling is high there. And like Dave said, sorry, Gav.
I was going to say, I totally agree. My only caveat is he doesn't offer anything over the middle, which is what I think the Steelers need to be, you know, they need to have a couple of people coming through that are going to do some damage there. That's my only knock on him, really, that he doesn't have that kind of, you know, lateral kind of movement to bring that.
Yeah.
Because it's a shame, because he's got the size and toughness. You'd think he could.
I almost want a Washington and a Juju to kind of play that role. I know you've spoken a lot about this is what you want, and I agree with you, but I do wish those guys could develop into that, or one of those guys could take that role on.
I think maybe Juju is the guy.
Yeah.
But he just didn't do it. Didn't do it last year.
I just love a guy like this, where he's got the big frame, 6'4" build, and he just makes 50-50 balls, 70-30 balls. You know.
Yeah, no, I like him. I've just got him down underneath, you know, Pittman and Mims, for that kind of. You get more from them.
I think after that combine, I think he's going to be a riser. I don't know where he goes. That's why I kind of asked you yesterday what the buzz was on him, and somewhere anywhere from sort of back end of round two to the fourth round is what you kind of said, right? But
yeah. I could see that was early in the process.
Yeah, I could see him rising. I'm interested in him. You know, if he's there in the third round, I'd be happy with that. But yeah, who knows? I don't know.
Yeah, I mean the speed was impressive for sure.
I do like him though. He's put a red star on him, Gavin, on your little notebook.
For you.
Okay.